I want a cleaner to be strong, cost-effective, versatile, and safe. Use it when a solvent is needed to remove adhesive, ink, paint, and other stubborn stuff.
And in the process of this demonstration, I've been covered in ink, glitter, mixed media paint, and glue. I'm going to spray my hands with the best cleaner ever, and I'm going to rub my hands with it. Nice, it's like an olive oil. And then I'm going to take a paper towel and proceed to get it off my hands. I was covered in tons of ink, and my ink is off.
It feels like olive oil. Actually, it is made from food grade materials. Even when it's oily on your hands, you can either wipe it off with a paper towel or just wash it under water. Well, here's a discontinued label from our glue. Not that I think you're ever going to really have need to remove the ink off of a label, but I'm going to spray some on just to show you how strong it is. So you can see that's strong. If I wanted to remove it all the way to clear, I could just let it sit a little bit longer. First, here's a clear acrylic stamp, and I'm going to use Stazon. If you're familiar with Stazon, you know that it's a solvent ink pad that's made for stamping on surfaces where you don't want it to be removed, like stamping on glass or acrylic or porcelain or whatever. So I'm going to stamp on this piece of glass. And I'm going to set it aside to dry so that we can really do a good test on it. Okay, there's been plenty of time for it to dry, so just spray a little cleaner on the glass. And again, if it's something you think is going to have trouble, you can always let it sit. But see, this comes right off. And for the stamp, so you'll want to wash that off, rinse it off. You know, I just noticed on this glass that all of the little legs have fallen off except for one, and there's all this old sticky dried up adhesive residue. See that? So let's clean that off. This would be the kind of thing that if you start to scrub and you see it's coming off but you don't want to work at it, just let it sit for a minute or two and it'll loosen right up. If you're like me, you probably have stamps that have been put away dirty, or you've bought them used and this is the condition that they are. So I'm not sure what ink is on them, but let's just clean them up. And you can use either a cloth or your scrubber or however you normally clean your stamps. And if you're finding that they're having a little bit of difficulty, you can always let it sit for just a little bit, not very long though. So scrub it like that. And then you can just wipe it off with a paper towel. You will want to rinse it under water or use a little soap if you want. So that's nice. Here's a stamp that I stamped with some pigment ink and I let it dry overnight. You'll want to get it into the little nooks and crannies. And you will want to wash this underwater.
I was very impressed with how it cleaned the stamps. Every bit of ink came off of the stamps.
Yeah.
They looked brand new.
Oh, it's the best one. We had pink binders, pale pink binders with black ink, and it got it off when no other product would get it off at all.
All sorts of sticky and adhesive and who knows what on it. So what else does it do? It'll clean the adhesive off your die-cut mats. It takes off old duct tape residue. It's all dried up and hard. So what I did was I sprayed this on and I did let it sit just a little bit. Let's see.
That's amazing. That's amazing. If I weren't being taped, I would say it a little differently. That is really amazing.
You can remove labels from containers and clean paint brushes and painting tools. You'll just take glitter glue off of your clothes.
Remove sticky items like polymer off your hands and glitter glue off your pants. See? No glitter glue. It's gone.
Sharpie marker, enamel paint. You can see, it's just dissolving it. Okay, even spray paint. Okay, it's dry. So let's take a squirt of this. And if you're feeling generous, put it out outside of your craft room. I've used it to remove silicone sealant from my hands. I've used it to remove chicken soup and some odd spots that I don't know what they were on my husband's clothes, so we've been using it in the laundry. Just spray some of this on. Thought you might be interested to see what happens from it just sitting for a little bit longer. A word of caution, just because it's safe for skin, has no fumes, and it feels like baby oil, it's really, really strong. So if it's going to remove spray paint, there's the possibility of removing things that you didn't intend to remove. I was cleaning my trimmer, and I walked away and let it sit for too long, and it removed the paint right off of the metal. Now, it didn't happen on...
because it must be applied by a different process.
So do I have any tips? Let's see. Well, if something seems to be extra stubborn, just let it sit for a little bit. Don't let it sit too long, and just kind of test it every once in a while. Always test it on fabric, on your clothes, in an inconspicuous spot. Haven't seen it cause any problems, but you never know. Don't dilute it. It's an oil-based product, so you can't dilute it, but you won't need very much when you're cleaning. And if you find that it removes some adhesive that you wanted, you probably can re-sticky it with the best glue ever. Remember to wash it off with water, maybe a little soap when you're done. And don't wash your tools first. For example, if you have a brush to clean, put it directly on the painted brush, because water and oil don't mix, so you won't be able to get the cleaner really onto your brush if your brush is wet ahead of time. And that's it. Enjoy.